something like directing or starring in a film or being involved in the writing process or doing Sundance. What for you at this point in your career is the most fulfilling?
To keep going. I think the most fulfilling is to keep working and also feel like there's new terrain to explore and that you haven't found things yet that you're looking for. You're in search, and the work is the search engine. The work is what reveals things to you that keep you going, and the fact that you haven't really gotten to where you think you may want to go keeps you moving. I think that motivation is what moves me.
You really don't feel like you've gotten where you want to go?
I guess not. That's otherwise I wouldn't have said that. Yeah, I guess not.
But when you look back at your accomplishments, and I mean that personally and professionally, you feel like there are still benchmarks that you want to reach?
Yeah, I don't look at the... I don't. I had a situation the other day that was really weird, and I didn't like it. I was at a place at a festival where they had clips of my career, and I hadn't seen it. And they showed clips going all the way back to 1960 when I started. I was about 20, 21. As I looked at the clips, I thought, oh, that's terrible. Oh, I just thought, oh, my God. You know, well, you could see some improvement along the way, but none of it got to where you might want to be. But at the time, you weren't thinking about that. You were giving everything you could to your performance and the character. Now you look back on it and you say, oh, that could have been better.
Robert Redford, I feel like maybe you're just self-loathing because you can't look at the
well,
work you've done and
also.
Say,
that's,
no, 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 that was terrible. Oh, that was terrible. Come on.
Well, look, if you came from a family, an old, old Celtic family that immigrated from Ireland, and they told you, pretty dark bunch, that told you if something good happened, there must be something wrong with it, then that's your inheritance.
Wow, that is dark.
It's right out of Beckett. SOS call over. This is the Virginia Gene with an SOS call over.
This film did not seem like it would have been that much fun to film, but I have to say, I am so impressed because it is gutsy to make basically a silent film. Especially when you have a man of your stature up there and they're like, no, no, no. Don't speak. Don't talk. We don't want to hear that voice.
That's one of the things that drew me to it, was that there was no dialogue. I think all that, by the way, all the things you're saying belongs to the celebration of JC. It's his concept. He's the guy that wrote that there's no dialogue, not me. I was drawn to it because there was no dialogue. I was drawn to it because it was one man alone in a dire situation. And it also involved a man alone who was a good sailor, but not an expert sailor, which meant that when the crisis came, he was going to have to go on instinct and figure things out in the moment and improvise. That was very attractive. All that was inherent in the script that drew me to it as an actor. On a simpler basis, it allowed me to go back to my roots. So that's how I started, just being an actor. And to forget whatever achievements you may have had, to come through and go back, you know, there's a great T.S. Eliot poem that says, let us not cease from exploring, that we might come back to the place where we started and see it as if for the first time. I've always liked that, you know. So you just keep going and then you come back and say, oh gosh, this is where I started. And that felt good.
When you look at this again for the first time, as a man, alone, you, a camera, and a set of extraordinary circumstances, what was the one lesson you were really glad that you had learned throughout the course of your career that you could bring this time?
Oh, God. The value of silence. That's always been important to me. I think as an actor, I felt that listening was as important as talking. And silence had its own virtues. Silence had its own dramas, depending on where it occurred. And this film is filled with noisy silence. You're on a boat out in the middle of the ocean where there's no other human beings. There's no mechanism. There's no planes and other boats or anything like that. There's just nature. And it gets very, very noisy, but it comes out of silence. I thought that was really interesting also, you know.
Right now, there is sort of this thing in the zeitgeist where you've got Captain Phillips and Gravity and all is lost, and it's these tales of a singular person in these tremendously arduous circumstances. Why do you think that story is being told right now?
Well, that's a good question. I don't know about the other films. I of course, I haven't seen them. They sound like they're all good. There's a lot of good films, I think, that are coming out this fall. I'm sorry there's so many. Seems like they're being cannibalized. It's not fair. But it sounds like they're all really good films. I don't know why. I think there's a zeitgeist for that kind of stuff. Something gets in the air and it has its own infection, you know, it has its own appeal, and suddenly everything's going that way. What happens? What gets in the air? I don't know. It's just something. It's some extra energy gets in the air that brings people to the same topic.
This is the Virginia Jean with an SOS call. Over.
Talk to you, Robert Redford.
Nice talking to you.
Thank you so much, sir.
It's so great, yeah.